So what are you shooting for here? Just even layer?
We're wetting the epoxy into the, wetting the cloth out. What we want to do is get the cloth completely transparent by saturating with the epoxy. But you want too much on it. You want to spread it out. You want it nice and even, so we'll just keep spreading it out until we run out and we'll mix some more.
Right. So you're looking for an even color. Is that indicator
Not necessarily the color, but you want the epoxy to completely wet the cloth out. So the weave, so it's completely transparent.
So you can't see the weave is no longer raised,
Well, it's raised, but it's just not as visible. And the other thing you want is you want a nice even coat. You don't want a bunch of bumps in it because they just have to sand that down later.
Right. Now, what about that little circular design there? It's pretty. That's going to show when the project's complete, that will go.
Yes. It's the joint. They can't ship these panels because they're 14 feet long. They can't ship them.
Right.
In one piece, so they ship in halves, and that's the joint where you splice them together.
Okay, and it's interesting that they make it round because I guess that doesn't splinter or something.
No,
What's the thought?
Well, the reason is it increases the surface area of the joint.
Okay.
And that gives it more surface for binding, which makes it stronger, in theory. I don't necessarily agree with that, but that's what, in theory, it works.
So more surface area of joining.
Yeah,
more contact area.
The builds I've built before had buck joints, just a straight line across there, and they just did fine.
Yeah.
I think it'll look nice on this panel board. I really do.
I think it will,
like it
too.
I wouldn't like it on a kayak. I don't like their kayaks.
And you said that probably if we can, we're going to try to get a logo after it's all finished epoxying, put a waterproof logo adhered to
it. It'll be laminated under a layer of epoxy, yeah.
Okay, under one of the layers of epoxy.
Yeah, another varnish over it, it'll be.
So somebody could theoretically customize, if we had families in here doing paddle boards, and, you know, we don't want to, you know, misplace paddle boards, they could theoretically laminate and personalize their paddle board with family photos or something like that.
They put a family crest on there, a family album, they can do anything they want.
Okay,
really.
I like that idea.
Yeah,
you get artistic here. We could have a competition eventually.
I've done that a lot of times with some kayaks and put things on there for people that I cut out a real thin laminate or fabric. You can laminate fabric on those if you want to.
Wow, that would be pretty too. So this can also be a work of art. I mean, beyond being a project for the family while they're here, they could actually is if the some of the members of the family have an artistic event, they could design what they want to put on it. That could be part of the process.
The family to bring in something like that and design what they want. Maybe we could print it up for them.
Exactly, we could print it up for them, and boy, what a memento for a vacation. Or you can't buy a customized, or you can, but you'd spend a lot of money on paddle board. So I love that idea of it. Now, Ron, I have to ask you something. There's a definite deeper stripe in there near the joint. Is that going to persist? Or?
That was some epoxy. This is the inside, so we're not worried about that. I sanded the other side down so you wouldn't see anything.
Oh, okay,
Yeah, this is the inside, so I wasn't too worried about that.
I see.
But the other side, yeah, I've sanded that down really well, so that didn't have even see that.
Well, this is going pretty fast. I'm amazed. How many layers of this will it take?
It'll just take one on the underside and probably put at least two on the top side.
Wow. This actually looks like fun.
It is. Hired because I don't do this. I was hoping I'd get the opportunity to go in there.